if we are walking also, suddenly if we hit by the wall or hit by the chair, we will get a bruising or a blackened area where we got hit. That we call it as contusion. And next, cyanosis. So cyano means blue. So cyanosis means bluish discoloration of the body. So why we have a bluish discoloration means because of the respiratory abnormality, we have more amount of deoxygenated blood in our body. Because of that, we will have the bluish discoloration. Next, depigmentation, loss of normal skin color, which is depigmentation. Means we are losing our skin color. So here you can see the picture about cyanosis. So the bluish discoloration of the face. So this is because of more amount of deoxygenated blood in the body. And dermatology, which is the diagnosis and treatment of skin conditions. And the physician, we call him as dermatologist. And next, diaphoresis, profuse sweating. So more amount of sweating, we call it as diaphoresis. And ecchymosis. Ecchymosis is like a blunt trauma, just like contusion. Contusion is small, but ecchymosis will be a larger trauma. You can see a very big blackened area. So that is ecchymosis. Nothing but because of the hemorrhage, if the blood is collected under the skin, if you can notice that blackened area, if it is bigger, then it is ecchymosis. If it is a very smaller one, then we call it as contusion. Next, erythema. Erythema is because of, for example, suddenly you touch the hot pan. What will happen? Suddenly your skin will become red. So that reddening of the skin, we call it as erythema, because of more amount of blood supply to that particular area. Because of that only, it looks red in color. And eschar. Eschar is a scar, very thick scar, because of burns. So psychiatrics is just a normal scar. But eschar is a very thickened scar that formed because of burnt area. So the normal scar is different from burnt scar. Hirsutism. For certain females and males, if you recognize, they'll have more amount of hair on their body, on their hands and legs. So that condition, we call it as hirsutism because of excessive production of testosterone hormone. Are you following me?
Yes, ma'am.
You can able to understand, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
So this is ecchymosis. So this red blackened area was very big, because why we have this color is because the blood is collected under the skin. Contusion will be very small. You can see a very small blackened area. So this is ecchymosis. This is because of blunt trauma. If someone got hit very deeply, then the ecchymosis will come. It takes a long period of time to resolve. But contusion, it takes very less period of time. Hyperemia. Hyperemia means more redness of the skin because of increased blood flow. For example, if you know the people who are living in Ooty and Kodaikanal, if you see, their cheeks will look red in color because more amount of blood will be flowing into their cheeks and nose. So that we call it as hyperemia, increased redness of the skin. Hyperpigmentation, abnormally increased pigmentation, like more darker in color because of more production of melanin, that we call it as hyperpigmentation. And keloid. Keloid is very thick scar. So not because of burns. If any scar, it is very bigger, then we call it as keloid. Keratosis, excessive growth and thickening of epidermis layer, we call it as keratosis. Because the skin layer is made up of keratin. So abnormal increase in that layer, we call it as keratosis. If you see OSIS or ASIS, then that means abnormal condition. And lesion. Lesion means any normal injury. We call it as lesion. So general medical term for injury is lesion. And nevus. Nevus means it was like a birthmark. So which is pigmented birthmark. We also call it as mole. Normal our mole or birthmark, we call it as nevus. So the medical terminology for birthmark. So this is keloid. So which happened because of burns. So the scar because of burns is very thicker. And pallor. Pallor means abnormal paleness of the skin due to decreased oxygenated blood. And petechia. Petechia was minute hemorrhages. I'll show you in the picture what is petechia. You can see the little spots of red colored spots. So that is because of very minute hemorrhage. Photosensitivity. For some people, they can't tolerate the heavy sunlight also. Their skin will become very red. That we call it as photosensitivity. And plastic surgery. So reconstruction or repairing of the body structures, we call it as plastic surgery. And pruritus, which is severe itching. So due to certain, if they are not tolerable to certain substance, they'll have severe itching. And purpura. Purpura is skin hemorrhage due to fragile blood vessels. So this is pinpoint skin hemorrhages or petechia. This is petechia. Petechia will looks like this because of minute hemorrhages. And this is purpura. Purpura is hemorrhaging of the skin without any injury or trauma because of weakened blood vessels. The blood vessels got weakened. So easily it will rupture and that will create like this. This is very common in old age people. This is purpura. And purulent. Purulent is any infection which produces pus, dead bacteria and white blood cells and tissue debris at the infected area. That we call it as purulent. And strawberry hemangioma. The blood collected under the skin, it looks like a strawberry shape. So that's why we call it as strawberry hemangioma. And suppurative. Suppurative means anything contains pus. Pus was produced, then we call it as suppurative. It was suppurative, means pus producing. Urticaria. Urticaria means eruption of veils, for example, if the person is having severe itching. So after severe itching, if you notice, the reddened spots will be there on the body. So that we call it as urticaria or hives. So itching with the veils. So that reddened area, we call it as veal because of itching. And verruca. Verruca are warts, which is because of growth of benign growth of virus. This is strawberry hemangioma. You can see this looks like a strawberry shape. So this is actually a birthmark. So it will be like that only. And cyst. Cyst is fluid filled sac under the skin is cyst. And fissure. Fissure means crack like lesion on the skin. Usually you can see on the foot. Near the foot, you can see the crack-like lesions. Laceration. Laceration means torn or jagged wound. For example, if you fell down, your wound will be like a dragged wound. That we call it as laceration. Macule. Macule is flat, discolored spot on the skin. And nodule. Nodule, if the mass is larger than 0.5 centimeters, then we call it as a nodule. So this is actually the cyst. Fluid-filled sac under the skin. So this is here the fluid-filled. Because of the filling of fluid, the skin was raised. This is cyst. So you can see these are cyst. And this is fissure. So this is very common if the for males. They usually work for more period of time in soap and all. So because of that, they'll get fissures on the skin. And this is nodule, sorry, this is macula. Macula is a darkened spot on the skin, is macula. Nevus means birthmark, that was different. Macula, this is macula. This is nodule, which is more than 0.5 centimeters, then we call it as nodule. And papulae. Papulae means if the nodule was less than 0.5 centimeters, then it is papulae. It is more than 0.5 centimeters, then it is nodule. Pustule. Pustule means you can see that the pimples on the on it, if it contains pus, then we call it as pustules. Ulcer is open sore of skin, so that may be because of any injury. Vesicle is small fluid filled riser spot, just like blister. After burns, if the skin get blisters, right, after burns, after minor burns, that we call it as vesicle. You can very commonly notice, for example, if we accidentally step on the silencer, immediately we will get a fluid filled blister. So that is actually vesicle. And veal is allergic skin reaction. Because of severe itching, they will have the reddened spots, that we call it as veal. So this is papules. Papules are less than 0.5 centimeters. And this is pustule, which contains pus. Usually you can see these pustules around the nose also. And this is ulcer. This may be because of any injury. It may be because of acid or any burn. This is ulcers. And this is vesicle. This is because of burns, first degree burns. And this is veal. After severe itching, you will have the reddened spots. This is veal. It looks like a round circle. That's why they named it as veal. And abscess. Any collection of pus under the skin, we call it as abscess. And acne. Acne means pimples. So what is pimples means? Inflammation of the sebaceous glands. So with papules and pustules, we call it as acne. So if it has any fluid, then we call it as papules. So if it has pus, then we call it as pustules. Acne rosacea. Acne rosacea means very small pimples. You can see around the nose. That is acne rosacea. Acne vulgaris, which is teenage acne. So usually the teenage people will get the pimples. That we call it as acne vulgaris. Comedo, papules and pustules, like that will be there. Albinism, which is a genetic disorder, unable to produce the melanin. So their skin will look very white in color. Their hair, skin, even they'll get red eyes. Basal cell carcinoma, which is cancerous tumor in the basal cell layer. So which is common cancer, but rarely it will pass to the other organs. Metastasize means it will pass to other organs. Rarely metastasize means it will rarely pass to other organs, or else it will be not dangerous. Burns. So if any skin damage due to fire, electricity, ultraviolet light, caustic chemicals means acids. Percentage of skin burned, we call it as, we differentiate by rules of 9. So this is basal cell carcinoma. We also call it as skin cancer. It is not that dangerous because it won't spread to other areas. And coming to the burns, we classify the burns into 3 degrees. First degree, second degree and third degree. So in the skin, we have the 3 layers, epidermis, dermis and subcutaneous. If epidermis alone got injured, then we call it as first degree burns. So vesicles are very common in first degree burns, means blisters. And it was slightly painful, the skin will become red and damaged only to the epidermis. And this is second degree burns. So the damage to the epidermis and dermis, so which is very painful with blisters and damage to both epidermis and dermis, and skin will become red. If damage to the epidermis, dermis and directly this hypodermis layer will be visible, so then we call it as third degree burns. So coming to cellulitis, which is acute infection to the entire skin. So the entire skin of our body will get inflammation. Then we call it as cellulitis. Next, decubitus ulcer. So these are the ulcers very common for bedridden people. If the people are being bedridden for long duration, they'll get ulcers under the skin. And digangrene. So which was the late stages of gangrene, the affected area will become dry, blackened and shriveled. So this is due to death of cells. And eczema. Eczema means superficial dermatitis. The person will be having redness, weasels, itching and crusting. And gangrene, which is tissue necrosis, which means death of the tissue because of loss of blood. Ichthyosis, the skin will become dry, scaly and keratinized. Then we call it as ichthyosis. Impetigo, highly infectious bacterial infection with pustules that rupture the and outer crust over. And Kaposky sarcoma, the skin cancer to the AIDS patient. We call it as Kaposky sarcoma. So this is eczema. You can see the crusting around the eye. The skin will be reddened in color. This is eczema. Malignant melanoma, which is dangerous skin cancer. So which begins in the melanocytes and it will spread to the other areas also. Pediculosis means lice infestation. Means in our hair, if we have lice, more lice, then we call it as pediculosis. We also call it as pale. Psoriasis, which is chronic inflammatory conditions. So with papules, silvery scale patches will be there all over the body. That is psoriasis. Rubella. Rubella, we also call it as German measles, which is contagious viral infection. And scabies. Scabies is mite infestation. So if any mites got infested, then we get scabies. So this is malignant melanoma, which is highly dangerous. And it is it will spread to other areas also. Basal cell carcinoma was less dangerous than malignant melanoma because it can spread to other areas. And this is psoriasis. So you can see the crusting. So the skin will have white patches. This is psoriasis. And sebaceous cyst, the sebum filled sac around the sebaceous gland, we call it as sebaceous cyst. Squamous cell carcinoma, which is cancer to the epidermis layer. It may go to the deeper tissues and it may spread to the other areas also. SLE, systemic lupus erythematosus, so which is a chronic disease to the connective tissue, injuries to the skin, joints, kidneys, and produces red, scaly, butterfly-like rashes will be there. Tinea, which is fungal infection, which include itching and scaling of lesions. And tinea capitis, if this fungal infection to the scalp region, then we call it as tinea capitis. If this fungal infection to the foot region, then we call it as tinea pedis, which we also call it as athlete's foot. And varicella, varicella means contagious viral infection. We also call it as chicken pox. Vitiligo, so the skin pigment will be lost. So they'll have milky white lesions all over the body. Wet gangrene, if the gangrene is been infectious and pus producing, then we call it as wet gangrene. So digangrene means no pus formation. So this is varicella or chickenpox. I think we all got affected with chickenpox in our early stages. And alopecia. Alopecia means baldness or loss of hair. Carbuncle. Carbuncle means furuncle or involving severe hair, several hair follicles. So furuncle means bacterial infection, particularly to the hair follicles. Redness, pain, swelling will be there. Onychia. Onychia means infected nail bud. Paronychia means infection to the skin around the nail. Coming to the clinical laboratory test, culture and sensitivity. If the skin is got infected with any bacteria, then they will remove the scrapings of the skin and they will test it. And they will come to a conclusion what type of antibiotics will suit for that infection. Biopsy. They will remove a piece of tissue and they will put under the microscope and they will find the diagnosis. What is the problem? For example, biopsy will be mainly done for malignant melanoma, basal cell carcinoma. Exfoliative cytology, they will take the scrapings of the cells from the tissue to see under the microscope. Frozen section, the thin piece of tissue is cut from the frozen specimen for rapid examination under the specimen, under the microscope. Fungal scraping, if the person is having any fungal infection, like tinea pedis, tinea capitis, then they will take the lesion, scrapings from that lesion, and they will test under the microscope. Grafting. Grafting was usually done for burns. So they will take the skin from some other part and they will put a plastic surgery at that particular part, wherever the burns is there. That we call it as grafting. So transfer of skin from the normal area to the another site to cover it. So grafting was of different types, allograft. So they'll take the skin from other person. Then we call it as allograft. If the skin graft is taken from the same person, then we call it as autograft. If the skin graft is taken from some other animal other than human, such as such as pig, then we call it as xenograft or heterograft. So this is actually applying a skin graft. The person is having some burns in this area. They have taken the skin from other area and they are putting it. This is freshly autographed. So this is to the leg. And next, dermatome. Instrument which is used to cut the skin for transplantation, then we call it as dermatome. Dermatoplasty, which means skin grafting. Cauterization, which is destruction of tissue by using the chemicals, electricity, heat and freezing. So it is done for gangrene, dye gangrene and wet gangrene. Cryosurgery, with using extreme cold, they will destroy the tissue. Cartridge, removing the superficial skin lesion with the scraper. And debridement, removing of foreign material or dead or damaged tissue from the wound. Electrocautery, with using the electric current, they will destroy the tissue. Incision and drainage, they'll make the incision and drain the material such as pus. And chemaberration, so they will remove the tissue with the help of chemicals. And dermaberration means with using wire, brushes, sandpapers. Usually this is done for removing the tattoos and scars. Laser therapy, they will remove the lesions with using the laser beam. Liposuction, so the removal of fat under the skin with means of suction, we call it as liposuction. And rightidectomy, surgical removal of excess skin, then we call it as rightidectomy. Coming to the pharmacology, anesthetics. Anesthetics is used to deaden the pain. So before surgery, they'll give anesthesia. Antibiotics, that is to kill bacteria. Such as cellulitis, systemic lupus erythematosus. In all these cases, they'll use antibiotics. Antifungals like Tinea capitis, Tinea pedis. In these cases, which is a fungal infection, ringworm infection, like and athlete foot, they'll use this antifungals because it is a fungal infection. Antiparasitics. This is to kill the mites and lice. Antipuritics. This is to reduce severe itching. Antiseptics to kill bacteria, and antivirals. This is to treat herpes simplex infection, and corticosteroid cream, which is a powerful anti-inflammatory. This is mainly used to treat the erythema. And coming to the abbreviation, BCC, basal cell carcinoma, which is less cancerous, and BX means biopsy. C&S, culture and sensitivity. Decups, decubitus ulcers, ulcers to the bedridden people. Derm means dermatology. FS means frozen section. HSV, herpes simplex virus. IND, incision and drainage. ID, intradermal. Usually injections are given intradermally, such as insulin. MM, malignant melanoma, which is highly cancerous. And SCC, squamous cell carcinoma. And SG, skin graft. SLE, systemic lupus erythematosus, and STSG, split thickness skin graft, and subcutaneous UV, which means ultraviolet.